This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your host, Casey and Jay.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I can do anything I want to, people, at any time I want to.
No, we're cooking with evil guys.
Get mad now!
What
the voice of people must be heard. Bigot, rape, and discrimination. The crime which are weakening America against you.
Hey, let's get this party started.
Mom?
Hey everybody, this is the Openly Hostile Opinions Podcast. I'm Jay, that's Casey.
What's up, you whores? Fuck Tom Brady.
Oh, we're gonna
You're
get
a
ready
bitch.
To do it, huh?
You're a little bitch.
Well,
fuck you.
We'll get to that. Anyway, yeah. I just want to apologize in advance. I sound like crap because I'm getting over a cold or
it's
flu or whatever.
It's his turn to be sick, not mine.
Yeah, it's my turn. So if you hear some snorting, some sniffing, some coughing, my sincerest apologies.
At least you're not crying like a little bitch. Like
jeez.
Tom Brady.
Fucking ruthless.
I'm sorry, I fucking hate him. He's the most overrated piece of shit in my life.
Let's be honest with ourselves for a second here. The only reason we all hate Tom Brady is because he doesn't play for our team.
No, I fucking...
Mm-hmm.
No, like I said,
if he played
man,
for the Cowboys, you'd be happy.
No, I wouldn't. Hey, Tony Romo played for the Cowboys. Fucking hate him.
Yo, that's because Tony Romo sucks.
Yeah, when he's good when he shows up, and then he's like, oh, I'm fucking Jessica Simpson or used to or whatever, so, you know, I'll show up when I want to. Fucking piece of shit.
Yeah, well, I mean, arguably numbers-wise, anyway, Brady's the best quarterback that ever lived.
Yeah, they were saying that, and they're like, he's the best there ever was, no doubt about it. I'm like, that's your fucking opinion. Go fuck yourself.
Well, like I said, according to the numbers, it's true.
Yeah, whatever.
Not that I like it.
His line makes him good. Like I was telling my friend the other night, I was like, that one year that his line was hurt for like 3 weeks, they lost every single game.
He's got a lot of weapons he can throw to down the field.
Yeah.
He's got
his team makes him good. That's about it. That's about it. So, Brady, go fuck yourself.
I mean, and Belichick's a hell of a coach.
Yeah.
Cheating bastard, but a hell of a coach.
I know. That's the thing. I'm like, so people are saying he never got caught, but they still find him and still suspended him. Why? Why'd you wait till after the Super Bowl to do it? And why'd you suspend him? Why is he still in the NFL? That's like NASCAR. Jimmy Johnson or something got caught cheating. Why is he still racing? Oh, because it causes drama. Go fuck yourself.
Keep in mind, it is a TV show. They need ratings.
I know. And that's the thing. Like, I don't know. I don't even really like football that much. I do. I enjoy it. But, you know, I bet you there's other people out there that are going fucking... Actually, I saw a bunch of posts where people were like, 2017 champions, New England Patriots, not my Super Bowl champions.
Hashtag.
Yeah. Hashtag.
Not my champions.
Yeah.
That's funny.
Fucking...
All right, hold your anger for a minute. Let's do the fucking...
I'm already getting fired up. Bitches.
I got an interesting one for us this week, man.
Yeah, this is sort of weird to me.
Yeah, this is from another one from our friendly company, Yards.
And that's the
based
thing.
Out of Philly.
I've never had a bad beer for Yards, so hopefully this is good. It's just a little weird to me.
Yeah, this one's called Poor Richard's Tavern Spruce.
Paul Richard. Oh, shit. We have a black screen.
What'd you do?
I don't know. Oops.
Do you not have Firefox open?
Oh, shit, I'm using Chrome.
Well, damn it, Casey.
Last week I stopped the video. This week I can't fucking do anything.
We have it set up for Firefox because you prefer Firefox, and now you're on Chrome.
Well, I switched to Chrome. Because for some reason, when I'm uploading shit to YouTube, fucking Firefox just crashes. It's like, fuck you.
You mean Google's browser works better with Google's platform?
Yeah.
No way.
It's just fucking bullshit.
All right, well, we can put it back to Chrome.
There we
now.
Go.
Okay. So, it's this is apparently based on Benjamin Franklin's original recipe. It's called a malt beverage brewed with natural flavors, molasses, spruce tips, and sprigs. So, this is going to be some pine tree beer.
Oh, God.
Let's give it a shot.
Liquefied fucking pine tree. Ding dong.
Different. It's not bad.
Yeah, it actually has a very mild taste.
Yeah, it's got a little bit of that pininess going on, but it's not like
gin. But not much. Yeah, not like gin. Oh, my God. Ugh, I hate gin. But for some reason, when you mix two shitty things like gin and tonic water, it tastes delicious.
I beg to differ.
Bombay Sapphire Gin tastes like shit. Tonic water tastes like shit. For some reason, when you mix them together, it's like fucking pure goldness. I don't get it, but whatever.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. It's very mild, actually. I'm surprised because I think Yards usually has a very strong tasting beer, but I think they didn't want to overpower the pine tree bullshit. You know what I mean? So yeah. I'm thinking it's only 5%. Yeah,
it's not bad.
It's not bad at all. I don't taste the molasses or anything like that at all. Spruce tips and sprigs. It says, mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's definitely got like a piney aftertaste.
But... yeah, I don't know. I thought it was gonna be completely different. It is actually not bad at all. If
you wouldn't drink a lot of it.
Yeah, I wouldn't either. But actually, it's just I don't know. I wish we gotta start pouring this stuff in glasses so we can see the color of it. Like yeah. A little like. One of those bourbon glasses. Mm, yes.
Yeah, swirl it around the cup so we can see if it has legs.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that I gotta give it one more taste here. And you said that this was old Benjamin Franklin's recipe. He brewed beer.
Yeah, it says crafted following Benjamin Franklin's original recipe is what it says.
What the fuck, man? Okay, there I'm getting a little bit more.
I don't mind it.
Oh, there it is. Yeah, okay.
It's not quite. Right. I was expecting full on licking an air freshener, but it's not bad.
Okay, yeah, air freshener. Yeah, we should put those around it or whatever like that. Yeah, I don't know. I've never had a bad beer by Yards actually, but this I wouldn't drink all the time.
No, really I'd have one or two.
Yeah, and I don't know. I'd say if I'd rate it, I would. I'd give it 3.5. That Tom Brady's overrated quarterback out of 5.
3.5 to inflated footballs. I agree.
Yeah.
There we go.
Fucking prick.
All right. Rage on, continue.
Rage. No, I'm done. That's all. You're a piece of shit. I fucking hate you.
Did you... I was rooting for the Falcons because they never won one. I don't have a dog in that fight, so I don't give a shit who won. Yeah. But the best part, and it was actually worth it, for the Patriots to win, because Roger Goodell, the commissioner of the NFL, has a fucking hard-on against the Patriots.
Against them or for them?
Against them. He fucking hates them, you know? That whole... everything he can fuck with them with. It's kind of the same way he is with the Steelers.
Yeah.
Who are the only...
Oh, sorry. I didn't want to do that. Sorry. I have something I want to show them later. Sorry about that.
Can we not deafen me?
Yeah, sorry. Are you awake?
All right, I'm awake now.
Go ahead, what were you saying?
Anyway, so he hates the Patriots just as bad as the Steelers, who were the only team smart enough to vote against giving him as much power as they did. But hey, what do we know?
What is this, Emperor Palpatine? Good.
The attack on my life has left me scarred and disfigured.
Unlimited power! Yeah, I never knew that. I never knew the commissioner hated Tom Brady.
Well, yeah, he does. But it was so worth it because he always gets booed when he talks anymore. But the booing when Goodell started talking this time after the after handing over the trophy was mm-hmm. was epic. It was so loud it sounded like a white noise machine. I've never heard it. Really? Here, let me go ahead. I got the sound clip for you. So here they're cheering for Tom. Michael Strahan's bringing up the trophy.
He just pulled it out in between the middle of his teeth.
Yeah. Now, here it is. Goodell talks.
What a wonderful football game tonight.
That is epic.
Oh, my God.
That's what NFL football is all about.
He's like, shit, Robert, people hate me.
Look, he's like...
And this is your fifth under your leadership.
He's like waiting for it to stop, and it just doesn't.
So he's like,
unbelievable achievement for your organization.
Wow.
Congratulations to your organization, to your fans, and your community.
Yeah, they don't stop.
We're so proud of you. Take your Super Bowl trophy home to New England.
And they hand it to Kraft, and it's back to cheering.
He's like, fuck, man, what am I doing wrong?
Look at it. Goodell just got the fuck out of there as quick as he could.
He's like, I'm going to get shot.
Anyway, that
I didn't know people hated them that bad.
Oh my god! Yeah.
I was scrolling through Facebook real quick and I saw something about it. And I thought they were booing the New England's owner or coach or whatever.
No,
that's fucking weird.
No, they were. Oh, excuse me. No, they were booing Goodell. No. I'm just
glad you're fucking miserable today, aren't you?
I'm like all hopped up on cold meds. Yeah, Kraft. What the hell's his name? Roger Kraft. John Kraft. Kraft. Idea. He's the guy who owns the Patriots.
Well, I know a lot of people are like sort of boycotting the NFL because of, you know, the penalty flags and all that fucking bullshit. It's like a fucking
everybody
reality
hates Goodell. Goodell's a dick.
I know, but it's like a fucking reality show. Like, oh, they're challenging to play. Uh-oh. Like, it's just drama bullshit. And it's like, can we just play fucking football?
There you go. Do you remember a couple of years ago when Putin stole Kraft's Super Bowl ring?
No. Oh, yeah, I did hear about that, actually. Yeah, he wanted it, so he's like, it's mine.
Yeah, I remember the story, how it went. He went to visit Vladimir Putin, and Vladimir's like, oh, that's a nice ring. Can I see it? You know, so he takes it off and shows it to him, and Putin's trying it on, you know? And then he goes, I could kill someone with this ring. Puts it in his pocket, gets surrounded by KGB agents, and just leaves.
That is so pimp. I'm sorry. I wonder if he does that with his women, like, you. I'm gonna fuck you tonight. There's nothing you can do about it.
I wonder if that's what he did to Trump's fucking testicles.
Probably.
I could kill someone with these. I would keep them.
Yeah, I was sorry. For all you viewers out there and everything, me and Jay were talking about this. What's that fucking piece of shit's name that speaks for Trump?
Oh, Sean Spicer.
Yeah, well, I guess Jenny McCarthy. Jesus Christ.
No, the other, her cousin, yeah. The funny one that's not.
What's her first name?
Melissa.
Melissa McCarthy. Yeah, she did a skit about him, and he gets all pissed, and he makes a speech or a press conference. He's like, she needs to calm down.
Oh, they're just like the White House of threats.
I know. It's just like,
nobody's
like,
taking it seriously.
Oh, what are you going to do? Like, you mad, bro?
Well, it can't be worse than Kellyanne Conway. That fucking fucking screaming banshee.
That sounds like a fucking trucking company.
Oh, my God, yeah.
Kellyanne Conway going down the road.
That woman is just, that every time I see her, she just looks angrier and meaner.
Yeah, they're all fucking scum.
She's like a fucking vile cobra.
Yeah, I know. It's just going to fucking bite your dick off.
Oh, my God. Our fucking White House right now, it's like a goddamn cartoon show.
I know. I fucking love it. Because it's pissing everyone off.
Remember, we have Damn It Donald t-shirts in stock now on our website.
Yeah, we're fucking, you know, promoting. We don't care. Like, we're promoting, buy our shirts.
Yeah, we get
There's no bullshitting, buy our stuff.
Yeah, if you buy our shirts, we get like $3 off of each shirt, and it would help pay for the, you know, hosting and stuff. So just saying.
Yeah.
We got coffee mugs and shit.
Yeah, because we're doing this bare minimum that we can with the amount of money, because, you know, I work a lot, Jay works a lot, and it's just, we still don't have money because bills suck. Yeah,
we don't expect to make any money off a podcast, because you don't, but it'd be nice to be able to pay for our hosting. Yeah, shit.
This is a lot of fun, though. Like, I'm having a lot of fun, whatever. No one buys our shit, we're still going to do this. Like we said, you're fucking stuck with us.
Yeah, we're going to, I'm going to fuck you till you love me.
I'm going to kill you until you die from it. Speaking of the Super Bowl, though, I have this just... I just have this little clip I want to show real quick. It fucking, I saw it, and it just, I love the internet because people are just so creative. And this fucking guy, Lady Gaga, jumped at the Super Bowl, and you were saying that they were saying it's pre-recorded.
Yeah, that part was pre-recorded. I was so bummed to hear that.
Yeah.
They didn't do that part live. That part was pre-recorded. The part that was actually live is when she came down on the platform. But anyway, go ahead and show your thing. I'll talk more about the halftime show when we're done.
Well, someone made a clip of... Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Jesus, I cannot do this today. I just can't. Okay, I just completely ruined it, but here it is. It's Lady Gaga. I just thought that was funny. I had to share that.
Okay, for those of you who are audio only here, it was Lady Gaga's little dive off of the off of the stadium there, and they took a clip of a WWE wrestler doing a freaking elbow drop.
Yeah.
It was fucking hilarious.
Ugh, I fucking love shit like that.
You know, I gotta say, man, that that halftime show was pretty damn good. That was almost as... That is damn close to as good as the one Prince did years ago.
See, everyone was saying that. I didn't think it was great.
I thought it was really good. She did good. She did it live. The vocals were live. Which, you know what, for all you little bitch pop princesses out there, she was fucking moving around like a goddamn snake and was singing live. I know. You can do it too, put away the autotune.
That one clip where that guy picked her up and she was like jerking and shit like that, someone was like, this is me trying to get my toddler out of the grocery store.
Yeah, yeah, well, fucking Lady Gaga sung that shit live.
Yeah, see, I don't like her, so fuck her.
I do.
I just don't like her. She's a piece of shit. I just she's an overdramatic, like, prima donna.
Yeah, she's artsy fartsy.
I know, but she just rips off Madonna. Everyone's like, oh, she's so amazing. I'm like, I've seen this before. It's called Madonna.
I'm okay with them bringing back Madonna. If you're going to rip something off, at least rip something off.
Yeah, I just, I don't know. She's like, I remember like at her shows and stuff like that, she's all dramatic. She's like, people. And she like pauses at the crowd and she's just like sucking it all in because she's probably a narcissistic cunt.
Oh, for God. It's called showmanship, you fucking miserable prick.
She's I am a miserable prick. Fuck her.
It's she fucking showmanship. Ship.
She can't sing, though. I'll give her that. But
I like her.
What did you like about the show? I
just thought it was really well done. The choreography was done well. The dance moves, the fact she actually sung live was great.
I don't know. Everyone was saying how great it was, and I was just like,
Well, they usually, the last few of them have been really stupid. Yeah. At least Lady Gaga went out and she did it cool. You know, the wire tricks are really neat. Yeah. They're flying around.
I don't know. I guess I really haven't watched a Super Bowl halftime in a long time, so maybe I was expecting more. I don't know. Like, I can't remember the last time I watched one. Maybe when Justin Timberlake whipped out Janet Jackson today.
Wardrobe malfunction, my ass. Yeah, that was so planned.
On purpose, dude. You could tell, man. He was like, I'm going to show these titties.
Yeah, because she conveniently had a piercing that covers the nipple. Yeah,
she had a pasty over it. She knew it was going to happen.
Well, it was supposedly a piercing, and then there's a shield that goes over it. Yeah, because, you know, everybody has those.
Michael Jackson was white.
Yeah.
And that was a halftime Super Bowl performance. I think it was in the 93 or something like that, when Cowboys and Steelers, Michael Jackson halftime show. You want to see a halftime show? Watch that shit. Motherfucker was like teleporting all over the place. Like, there was these two huge screens on the side, and all of a sudden these fireworks came up and he popped up on top of it. He was like dancing, and then all the way on the other side he like dropped down and then came back up on the other side, started dancing, and then he just fucking popped out of the middle of the stage and everyone was going fucking nuts. that was a show.
But yet you have a problem with Lady Gaga.
Yeah, she's a bitch.
It's the same thing. It's just showmanship.
Her and Tom fucking Brady can get together and cry together.
Oh my God. You know, my favorite
this next song.
My favorite one. Sorry, I fucking my favorite one in recent memory was the Prince one. Did you see that one?
No, I didn't even see that one. Oh man, I heard people talk about it and shit. I don't know.
It was glorious. He was on his, you know, his symbol.
Yeah.
Well, he had this giant, slick black plexiglass stage that was in the shape of his symbol.
Yeah.
And it was fucking pouring down rain, just a deluge during this thing. And
deluge, good word. I like it.
Yeah. They actually called up Prince right before the performance. Says, "Hey, it's raining really bad. Are you going to be okay? You know, because this fucking stage is just one big oil slick waiting to happen." And in typical Prince fashion, he replies, "Good. Can you make it rain harder?" You know? And he goes out.
He's like, "You get God on speed dial."
And, you know, he turned it into a fucking prop because he's Prince and he's pimp as shit.
That's awesome.
You know, and he goes out there and he rips like the great big Prince guitar solos, and he has this fucking curtain that flies up that's like 50 feet tall and his shadow's projected onto it while he's ripping on that symbol shaped purple guitar.
Isn't that when he covered the Foo Fighters to basically tell him to fuck you?
Yeah, yeah.
Because
yeah,
they covered one of his songs and he hates that, so he covered one of their songs just to be a dick.
If you have,
and the Foo Fighters, I remember when it first happened, they were like, we have no idea why he covered her song. But little did they know, he's like, yeah, fuck you.
He's just, for some reason, he hates that.
Yeah, he doesn't like it when people cover his music, so he's just like, I think that's funny. Like, that's how I would do things. Like when Beckham Jr. or whatever his name is for the Giants, when he got really pissed at the game, he went up to the field goal net that they practice on,
yeah,
and he smacked it out of, you know, anger, and it came back and smacked him in the face. Well, everyone was making fun of him for it, like everybody. Well, I think it was the next week he scored a touchdown. It was a really good play. He runs up to the net and like starts like acting like he's shaking his hand and apologizing to him. Mm-hmm. That's great. Like, that is great. You take humiliation like that and you turn it into something like that. That's fucking awesome. I love it.
I'm going to share something here. Speaking of Prince, that explains that whole thing with him and the hating covers thing. Mm-hmm. And it has to be one of the funniest fucking things I've ever watched. Just please take 10 minutes out of your life to watch this and laugh your ass off. You know the director, Kevin Smith. He directed Clerks, Small Rats, sort of shit. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we're all familiar with who Kevin Smith is. Well, Prince loved his movies, Dogma, and especially loved it. And summoned him to Paisley Park. And only typical
summoned him
to Paisley Park. Yeah. So Kevin Smith it tells this whole story about Prince, and he goes up there and Prince asks him to make this documentary film, which will never see the light of day probably because it's in his vault, I'm sure. But Kevin Smith goes into great detail about some of the shit that just gives you an insight into what it's like in Prince's world. And I laughed so hard when I watched this, I literally fucking cried. You know, he's explaining about how Chaka Khan, you know, somebody covered her song, and Chaka don't like that. Chaka mad. Okay, Kevin Smith's like, Chaka mad? What do you want me to do about that? Chaka mad.
But like we were talking about one time, like celebrities were talking a lot about, you know, interactions with Prince and everything like that. And he's so rich, and I don't know if that's the thing, but he just expects everything. And if it doesn't happen, he doesn't understand why. Like, it was sort of like the Putin ring thing. Like, oh, a ring, I'm taking this. Because Jay was telling me he rented a house from an NBA basketball player or something like that. And a week later, he comes back and the whole house is purple. Like, everything's torn out. Everything's done.
Yeah, and the hair salon in the master bedroom.
Yeah, and the basketball player was like, dude, what's going on? He's like, oh, here's a couple million. It'll be back to normal by the time you... And then just put it all back to normal. Like, he's just... It's Prince.
You know, he put his, like, Prince logo on the gate to the door. And,
yeah, he's like, fuck you, whatever. I don't care.
Anyway, so that I shared that video on our social network on Thursday morning. It'll be available. Take 10 minutes out of your life and watch this shit because it literally had me streaming tears down my face. I was laughing so hard.
Oh, man, it reminds me of that Dave Chappelle skit. It's just so fucking funny. I miss him.
Prince actually said that was true, except for one thing. It's not that he's that great of a basketball player. It's just that Charlie Murphy sucks.
See, that's the thing. Like, Prince, like, when you first hear that, you're like, oh, Prince is being modest. And he's like, no. Like, you're like, oh, wow, Prince, you know, and then he's just like, they're just not that good. And he's like, oh, there it is. Oh, man, that's fucking hilarious.
So back to the whole Super Bowl thing. You got to hear this shit now. So crazy guy in chief, Alex Jones.
It's a war for your mind.
Yeah. Yeah. He believes the Lady Gaga Super Bowl ritual or a Super Bowl show was a satanic ritual.
It wasn't a satanic ritual. It just wasn't that good.
You know, when she caught the football, it was hailing to the Dark Lord. Who listens to this? How stupid do you have to be to listen to this crap?
So every NFL player that catches the ball is a Satanist because they're catching the Dark Lord.
I mean,
and wasn't the football white like that she caught? Wasn't it like all sparkly?
Yeah.
I'm like, wow. I'm like, if they have diamonds in hell, I want to go there.
Yeah, really? I mean, and Alex Jones is just insane. Oh, and as years go by, he gets worse and worse. Like 10 years ago, he was just talking about how, you know, 9/11 seems awful suspicious. And nowadays, he's just gone full on fucking retard. I shouldn't say that. That's not very nice, but whatever.
No, like, as I remember, he's always been like that. It's just he got famous for, you know, really getting into 9/11 and stuff. But even before, like, 9/11, he's been all fucking crazy.
The,
like,
new world order.
Yeah, and all this.
Fucking got Dave Mustaine believing all this shit now.
And just all this crazy shit. But he fucking – if you want some entertainment, go to just YouTube. And I might actually link this on Twitter just to show you people. Just watch, like, people have – synced up YouTube videos of him and his rants. He gets so angry and is so entertaining. He's like, they're gonna kill you, they're poisoning our water, and he just goes nuts. It is so fucking funny. I love it.
Well, you know what though, here's the deal. We both do internet radio. Mm-hmm. And he's rich and we're not.
I know.
God damn it, it was a satanic ritual. Lady Gaga's here to steal your children and poison your water. Are they really? No, but are we gonna wait until they do?
Oh, man.
But anyway, he puts this whole fucking thing on Facebook. It's hilarious. he claims that Gaga does rituals and pointing out she once wore a meat suit, which we all know she did.
No.
He says that the Super Bowl organizers are deciding to defile America and break our will by having us bow down to this. They say she's going to stand on top of the stadium, ruling over everyone with drones everywhere, surveilling everyone in a big swarm.
Of course he mentioned the drones. Of course he did.
To just condition them to say, I am the goddess of Satan, ruling over them with the rise of the robots and a ritual of lesser magic.
I think he watched Terminator a couple times too much.
I think he smoked the bad acid. he literally took the acid hits, rolled them up, and smoked them.
And see, that's the thing. Like, big shocker. But I actually listen to some of Alex Jones' stuff because, like, he's not crazy all the time. Like, some of the stuff, you're like, oh, okay. And, like, some of the stuff he said, he made good point. No, he's called some shit out, like, when the airports were going to put in body scanners. He said that a couple years, like, before they happened, and everyone's like, you're full of shit. And then, like, he's been writing stuff. But once he starts getting this, it's like, okay, Alex.
It's okay to be a skeptic, and it's okay to fucking fight the power and resist, man. I'm a child who grew up with Rage Against the Machine as a favorite band. I'm right there with you.
I just think he knows too much. Like, he says he has connections with the CIA and all these people, and I think they're telling him stuff, and he just, I think he knows too much. I don't know.
I think he's just crazy.
Yeah.
And that's, he's right up there. You know what?
Look, what I mean by that, like, look at all these people that are can't deal with the internet and how it makes them go nuts. I think it's the same thing. I think he just knows too much. I don't know.
I think maybe 50% of it's him being a little bit legitimately off his rocker, and the other 50% is he's a media mogul and he's very smart and can make money.
Yeah, exactly.
Just like Rush Limbaugh.
He's charismatic.
Words are hard.
I just fucked a pine tree. Jesus Christ. Now I'm really starting to taste it. I get more of the pine tree taste afterwards.
Well, I mean, Alex Jones is right up there with fucking Rush Limbaugh. Yeah. You know,
and that's
they
thing.
Just
like,
say
talk,
shit to yeah. sell their yeah. brand. Yeah. Bill O'Reilly's
yeah,
the same
Bill,
thing.
I fucking hate him. I can't stand
Sean
him.
Hannity. They're all
explain
the same.
That. I don't yeah. know Bill O'Reilly, you fuck. I hate him.
They're all
this
the
other
same.
Guy, the fucking crew cut guy. Fucking... I don't. Oh shit! I can't remember. He has white hair.
It's
like a fucking flat top.
Yeah, I know the one you're.
Yeah,
talking.
Why can't I think of his fucking name?
He's the liberal side of the thing.
No, he's on Fox News.
Oh,
he's very conservative. Shit! Why can't I fucking remember his name? I hate him too. He's a fucking.
I don't
piece
know.
Of shit.
I don't know what you're talking about. I thought you were talking about. Oh, what's his fucking face? I am so bad at recalling shit off the top of my head.
I know. Me too. I'm horrible with names. Like, I forget mine sometimes. You know, I just, you know, the only reason I remember mine is, you know, when the girl calls me when I'm, you know, giving anal to her. Sorry.
Stop is not your name.
Yeah, I know.
Ow, it hurts.
I don't know. For all you World of Warcraft fans out there, there's probably like none of you. But I always thought it'd be funny that if you were having sex with a girl and you were about to climax, you made the bloodlust noise.
What would that be? Would you like to demonstrate this?
I don't know. Let me see if I can find it.
Oh, you're not going to mime it?
It's actually a really weird noise.
If you don't play it on Firefox, it won't work.
I got it now. Wait, do I? Yeah, okay. Let's see if I can find it here. Because it's actually a really weird noise. And I cannot imitate it. Let's see if I can find it here. There has to be something on here. Yeah, here we go. Is that fucking, can you imagine hearing, like, if you were a woman and you were having sex with a guy and you heard that, what would you do?
I don't know how to react to that, really.
I don't either. There's actually, let me see if I can find this one. I'm going on a rant here, sorry.
Oh, good lord.
There's this game called Overwatch. It's actually pretty popular right now. And there's a character called Hanzo, and there's alts in the game. Like, you get a certain percentage of, if you do better, you get an alt, and then you do the alt.
What the fuck are you talking about? Non-gamer.
Ultimate. You get an ultimate. You do a bunch of stuff.
What does that mean? Explain.
It's like
to
a
us.
Power move.
Okay, thank you.
You have like...
It's a special move.
Yeah, it's a special move. Okay. And when you do the special move, he does this really weird shit. And it also sounds like he's coming. Let's see if I can play it here.
You go, wakateki okuro!
Yeah, okay.
Does it sound like he's coming?
Sounds like some vaguely Japanese shit.
Yeah, he's Japanese. All I right. think.
Well, Hanzo, kind of.
Actually, for anyone that doesn't even like video games or whatever, that game's actually pretty fun, Overwatch. I'm not a big first-person shooter game like player, like Bro of Duty. Hey, bro. But, yeah, it's actually a really fun game. You should play it sometime.
I'm not into newer games. I know, man. You have I like kids the retro life. Games. I just like retro games. You know what? I'm very... I've not progressed when it comes to my media. Like, I like the same music I liked 10 years ago. I stopped listening to anything new. I like the same video games I liked 10 years ago. I don't like anything new.
Man, like, a couple of weeks ago when I said I had Little John's fucking turnout for What Stuck in My Head, I listened to that this morning when I was getting a shower. Like,
I mean, at least that one's newer, but, like...
No, you know, I was listening to Poison to Well, a bunch of old shit that I was listening to way back in the day. I still listen to them. I just can't... And you're the same way you were talking about. You just can't find good music anymore, man.
Well, I put on the other day... I have a Google Play Music, which I absolutely fucking love. It's so worth the $10. Mm. But I put on their like new metal first station.
Yeah.
And it's all fucking whiny garbage. Nah. And it's all this deathcore fucking chug-a-lug breakdown tuned down so far it just sounds like fart noises.
Nah.
And then it gets to the chorus and it's
brutal, man. It's fucking brutal.
Yeah, and it almost is cool enough to get your head bobbing a little bit, and then the chorus kicks in and every one of them sings like a bitch.
Yep, tamponing it. You got a nice flow in music and then you just tampon it.
You stop the flow.
You stop the flow, man. Drives you fucking nuts.
I don't even mind clean singing if it's done right.
I know, but a lot of it isn't. Like, I used to really like Bleeding Through back in the day, and then they came out, I think it was their third album or something like that, and it was really good. And then you just realized that they basically sat down, they're like, we have to put a chorus here. Okay, well, it doesn't really, we'll make it fit.
I don't mind. I don't mind catchy music. I don't mind clean singing. I don't mind a mix of screaming and clean singing.
Yeah.
It's just got to be done well.
I know.
You know who always did it good, even though I'm probably going to get like laughed at for this one, is Fear Factory. Yeah, they always did it really well.
Yeah.
Burton C. Bell has a fantastic voice, both when he's doing his Fry screams and when he like does that chanty chorus.
Yeah, and you know why? Because Fear Factory keeps the fucking beat going. They keep it going and shit like that. A lot of other music where they start doing the chorus, it's a lot of open chords and, you know, fucking the drum beat slows down. Fear Factory, it might be an open chord, but the drums are still going, like, you know what I mean? And he's like singing, and it's just like, oh yeah, and that reminds me, don't listen to New Suicide Silence. It sounds like fucking Deftones went through a toilet. It's horrible.
I wouldn't listen to Suicide Silence anyway, but.
Oh, I used to love them. I used to love them.
Like fucking deathcore. You know what? I've actually gotten to
that's the thing back then when Suicide Silence and like. Came out, it wasn't called deathcore, it was just called music, and then once everything gets a label, it starts sucking.
I didn't like it when it didn't have a label. It just wasn't good. It's not my style.
Yeah,
I actually got really excited when I heard a band release another album in standard E. They thought the same thing that I did. You know, it's just getting to the point where everything's getting so downtuned, so man. Sludgy. Mm-hmm. The only way to make it sound energetic and wired again was to go back up to open E or standard mm-hmm. E. And you know what else is another good came out with a great album that I love is Annihilator.
Oh, I love Annihilator. Oh,
they're so good. Their album they came out with it was either last year or the year before, it was Suicide Society.
Mm.
And you know, it's standard E, and Jeff Waters is singing again, and he actually is doing it well, which is surprising. But it's really catchy. There's great catchy choruses, and it's very poppy in the choruses, but it's still very thrashy and very good music.
Yeah, I don't know. We've both been like this, me and Jay, for a while. It's just so hard to find music anymore. And then I don't know, even one good part of a song like sort of catches your eye anymore because no one's like creative anymore. It's with anything though. Like you have the internet, it's overdoing it. There's so much shit out there.
And you can fix everything. That's a big problem.
Yeah, I know, and that's like
you can sit there and copy and paste everything.
I was in a band and like our drummer specifically said I don't want to do that because it's just bullshit.
It takes away the human element of the performance.
Yeah, they go through the whole song, they take the best snare hit, the best hi-hat hit, the best drum hit, and they just copy and paste it all. And that's the whole song. That's why everything sounds generic. Like it sounds like a computer.
You know what? as far as the whole metalcore thing is concerned, I actually really liked Avenged Sevenfold's "Waking the Fallen." Love that album.
Time ago,
I know it's you know, very generic metalcore-y, but I really like that album. And I heard the remastered version of it the other day.
Yeah, you were telling
me
that.
It's like garbage.
It's like they tried to do this newer stuff.
They compressed the fuck out of it, and it, like, there was no range and dynamic. Yeah. You know, there's supposed to be quiet parts of a song and louder parts. Mm-hmm. It's not supposed to be the same volume the whole way through.
Yeah, and that's the thing. They didn't need to make it sound like newer stuff, because back then, that album actually came out a while ago. And it was, like, really, like, I seen him a long time ago with, like, 18 Visions, Poison Well, Dillinger Escape Plan. Who else was there? I forget who else was there.
I love Dillinger.
Oh, God. I don't know if I talked about this before, but it was the only show where I thought I was going to die. Like, I didn't know who Dillinger was. That's how long this was. And I'm just standing there like a little kid. I'm like, oh, what's going on, you know? And then all of a sudden, everyone's, like, fucking walking around. They start punching themselves in the face. And I'm like, okay. You know, calm down, bro. Like, what's going on? And I didn't know Dillinger was playing next. They didn't really announce it or anything. And these guys are sitting there punching themselves in the face. This one guy, I'm not even joking, was standing like this, and this guy is punching him in the stomach. Like, he's just fucking going at
him. Is this in the crowd, or is this on the stage?
This is in the crowd. This is in the crowd. And I'm like, what the fuck is going on? And then all of a sudden, Dillinger just rips this open cord. And they opened the mosh pit so hard, I fell and got trampled. Like, I had my hands over my face, but I was getting hit so much in the face by all the feet, I was like, I'm dying. Like, I'm going to die right now, because I was getting trampled. Like, just, it was the craziest fucking show. I couldn't get out. I couldn't breathe because I had people all around me. It was crazy. It was the best time of my life. Like, it was insane. And fucking,
I love that EP they did with Mike Patton.
Yeah, and Mike Patton actually came out and sang,
did he?
43% Born Rhythm.
He did?
Yes. It was amazing. And it was just so fucking cool, because people flip balls. They were already going nuts, and then Mike Patton came out and sang 43% Burn with them, and it was just insane. Like, I don't remember hardly anything except almost getting trampled to death, because I was having so much fun, it seemed like 5 seconds.
The best song that he did with them is when good dogs do bad things. That song is so fucking good.
They're such a talented band. And our friend Gordon.
Our friend?
Yeah, he's not a friend anymore. If you ever listen to this, Gordon, you're a fucking asshole.
It's more our acquaintance we put up with who was abusive and annoying.
Yeah, he was a piece of
shit.
And
pissed in my fucking heat register. Fuck you. Yeah,
he used to drink, and then he'd, like, pee all over the place.
that little bastard, one time I invited him over to my house, and we had a little party. I didn't invite him specifically, but he was in our group of friends. And he fucking gets all drunk, and he pisses all over my couch, and then he gets up in the middle of the night and pissed in my heat register.
Yeah.
That's the gift that keeps on giving.
Yeah, I remember he'd bring a girl over and stuff, and they'd wake me up and be like, hey, where's your laundry machine? He just pissed all over my purse and all my clothes. And I'm like, this way. Like, I was used to it. I was like, oh, you did it again? Well, okay.
Tell him some more Gordon stories. These are fun.
Oh, what else? What else? We were in a band together, and we were touring down south, and we were in Georgia. I got so mad at him, I started walking home to Pennsylvania from Georgia. Like, that's how mad I was. I was so pissed. I didn't even want to be around the same air he was breathing, so I just started walking home from Georgia to Pennsylvania. Like, I was, and thank God the band behind us, like, picked me up and were like, grabbed me by the shoulders, like, do you know what you're doing? And I'm like, okay. I snapped out of it, and I got in with them, and that motherfucker used to piss me off so bad about everything. He's just a fucking piece of shit.
What about the time you almost ended up in the threesome with the lesbians?
Which one was that? Was that? I don't know if I know this.
Gordon came out. Yeah, you do. You told it to me a while ago. Gordon came out drunk.
Which one was this?
All right. Well, since Casey can't remember the story, I can't remember. Casey knew a couple of lesbians, and they were getting frisky and basically inviting him to join in on his couch. So the deed's nearly about ready to go down, and Gordon, who Casey lived with at the time, even though knowing better than to invite Gordon to live with him, Gordon decides to come out all fucking drunk. Whoa! All right, then. Decides to come out all fucking drunk and piss in the closet directly behind the couch.
Oh, okay. They weren't lesbians. That's where you confused me. Yeah, they were just whores.
I thought they were lesbians.
No, they were just whores.
So he ruined, God bless you. He ruined the whole fucking thing by coming out all drunk.
Mm-hmm. He always ruined everything. He does. He was a fucking, like, crybaby
You've had a lot of success with roommates over the years.
Yeah, actually, Shane and Sam. Shane, you listened to this. You guys were awesome. You were the best roommates I ever had.
Yeah, I'm talking about Jimmy too.
Yeah, just I don't know. I just a bunch of like, I don't know, just weird shit.
It's hard to live with people.
I know it is hard to live with other people. It's just people are different. Whatever. I just don't break up threesomes with lesbians. That's a horrible idea.
Or if you have a habit of getting drunk and then sleepwalking and peeing on things, maybe don't drink so much.
Yeah. Because I had friends. Every one of my friends always peed on stuff. I remember one friend, Kevin, like he was walking, picked up a rocking chair like a toilet seat and was peeing under it. Then he put the rocking chair down like a toilet seat.
I've never peed on anything.
I know, neither have I. I shit myself once when I was drunk, but never peed myself.
I mean, we've done all sorts of things, especially around Joe's place, because Joe... We all knew that one kid who was like had sort of the shitty family life where mom where it was out at the bars late at night. Yeah. And, you know, we all got drunk at his house. We all had that one. Well, for us, it was Joe.
Nah. Things would break in the wall and they put peanut butter on it to put the wall back.
I will take credit for that one. Thank you. We were wrestling and my head went through a wall.
I don't know how we're still alive.
Yeah. We got peanut butter and we put it over the hole in the wall.
Yeah, fucking Montgomery.
Patched it up, waited till it dried, and then painted it white.
Fucking Montgomery, man. I remember, actually, Gordon and Joe, I was actually the first people I was in a band with. And I just got off work, so I was wearing my work stuff and everything like that, and I had to go up to Montgomery real quick to get ready for this show. It was my first show ever. I was fucking nervous. I had no idea what was going on. There was a lot of people there. It was at a fire hall, I think it was. Mm-hmm. Well... These people
I was at that show.
Yeah, these people are just standing around there, and we just start playing and shit. I look around, and people are going nuts. And there's this guy over there. I think his name was Jimmy. He had a cane because his leg was fucked up. Well, the mosh pit started out, and all of a sudden, he fucking threw that cane and ran in. He broke his leg. and to me, at the first show, it wasn't nothing crazy, but, you know, 15, 20 people having a mosh pit for your first show, you're like, wow. You know, it makes you feel good. And then this guy's like, I was like, our music isn't that good where I'd be like, you know what, I'm going to break my leg.
Actually, I thought your stuff was really good.
Yeah, but it's just, you're your own worst enemy.
It was punk with death metal screams. It was pretty cool.
Yeah, you're your own worst enemy, though. And I was like, I thought that guy was so cool. Like, I went up and talked to him. I think his name was Jimmy or something. He had really thick glasses, I remember. And he was just like, I'm like, dude, why'd you break your leg? He's like, it was awesome, man. I was like, I'll never forget that. It was my first show ever, and this guy... that broke his leg in like a 20-person mosh pit. It was so cool. Like, oh, man. And then I fell in love with being in a band. And I was in a band for a long time, man. I remember one time I was in this horrible band called Red Hatchet Conspiracy.
They were bad, but they were fun bad.
Horrible. Because we focused too much on going nuts. We couldn't – we barely played an instrument. I guess like Sid from – Sex Pistols or something, you would say.
See, Casey's a vocalist, and he's a very good vocalist, but in this band, he played guitar. Yeah. He's not very good at guitar.
Not very good at guitar. And I remember our one show, it was like our third show or whatever. There was a prom going on. Everyone left their prom to come and see us.
Nice.
And what happened? Oh, this is going to happen worse. So all these people are standing in tuxedos and prom dresses that they paid probably hundreds of dollars for. Well, our lead singer gets hits his head off our other guitar player's guitar. He has bright blonde hair. Like, it looks like Children of the Damned type shit. Blood just leaking through his hair. Like, it looked like someone was dyeing his hair without their hands on it. It was so crazy. So Mark doesn't give a fuck because he's fucking crazy. Like, he's probably the craziest person I know. He just starts headbanging like nobody's business. Blood is just going like this all over the crowd. And there were strobe lights, so it's just all white. If you can imagine tuxedos and white prom dresses getting blood all over it. And I'm talking a lot of blood. And all these – the guys didn't care. They were like headbanging too and blood was flying. It was like an AIDS fest. But all the women were pissed. They were like trying to get us to pay for their prom dresses and shit. And I'm like, I don't think you get how, you know, broke we are.
I don't think you get how a metal show works.
I know. Like, don't go to a fucking metal show in a prom dress, you cunt.
I've only played a couple of shows ever. We were never in a band together, although we did talk about it.
Yeah.
We actually talked about reforming a band that Joe and Gordon were in without Gordon because Gordon pisses everybody off and replacing him with me. Shit.
And I don't even care if he sees this.
The only problem is Gordon's a far better guitar player than I will ever be.
I'll bet he's a really good guitar player. Really, it's just the
but fucking, the arrogance isn't.
Yeah, the vanity comes along with that.
He's got the fucking Eddie Van Halen thing going on, you know? Mm-hmm. It's like, yeah, you're good, but don't be an ass.
Yeah, it's just one of the hardest people I've ever had to try to get along with. Like, I remember one time, you know, there was condoms in my trash can from some girl. I don't fucking remember her name, whatever. Names aren't important. But my friend, the drummer at the time of the, we were in Kill a Messenger at that time. Our drummer, he was like, hey, man, I got to tell you something that's really weird. I was like, what the? He was like, Gordon was going through your trash can. I'm like, what? He's like, yeah, he found condoms in there and he thought you were fucking his girlfriend. I'm like, oh, my God.
You were a 20-something-year-old guy. Of course you
had condoms. Yeah, of course I'm going to throw it in people. Like, what do you think's going to happen? Jesus. And it's just, I don't know. He was a very hard person to get along with. But I miss being in a band. Talking about this right now, I'm just like, remember the crazy shit we did? Like, I remember the one show I just pulled my dick out. I was drinking and I was fucking wasted and people were going nuts and shit. I was just like, boop, boop, boop.
I never kept a band together for very long. I only played a couple of shows in my lifetime. Yeah. And I also have way bad stage fright.
Yeah, and that's the thing. Like, they were making fun of me. I don't face the crowd, I guess. And I never really noticed it until Jay was telling me. I guess it's a nervous tick.
Yeah,
they're ripping off Jim Morrison. I'm like, he did it for the same fucking reason, because he was nervous. It's like the guys from Dave Matthews. They wear sunglasses because they have really bad stage fright, and it helps with their stage fright. Well, I didn't fucking know I wasn't looking at the crowd.
That's why Lemmy always put his microphone up way high.
Yeah, I was too busy fucking screaming all my anger out because I was a young kid that was pissed off at everything.
Yeah, I was actually the vocalist for a punk band once. That was pretty bad. But, I mean, it was punk, so I could get away with being bad.
I don't know.
I don't sing.
Yeah, I remember adrenaline. I've never felt adrenaline like I have with fucking being in a band. Like, I remember one time I sprained my ankle really bad, and I didn't feel it till the next morning because I was so hyped up. And I remember going to the doctor's, like, this is one of the worst sprains I've ever seen. But that's just how amped up I was. I was like, I can't feel nothing.
Yeah, the bands that I played in, I played bass in, I did vocals in one band, and I played bass in two other ones, and, you can jump around a little bit when you're a bass player, but if you're a good bass player, you don't, because you're actually in charge of keeping everything in time.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, see, what happens a lot of times in bands is they take the worst guitar player and give them the bass. Mm-hmm. And you know what that creates? A shitty bass player. So if you actually care to learn your instrument properly, you know, you've got to, like, pay attention and do it right, because if you don't, then everybody misses their cues. The bass and the drums need to lock in together, and if they don't, then the guitar player doesn't know where the fuck to be, the singer doesn't know where the fuck to be, and the whole thing just sounds like pop. Or it all sounds like Chevelle or one of those other shitty bands that are fucking created by MTV.
I've seen them in Ozfest, and I wanted to kill myself.
They were in Ozfest?
Yeah. They were on the main stage, fucking right with Linkin Park, and it was the worst fucking bullshit I've ever heard. They were missing
Linkin Park garbage, too.
Oh, man. They were fucking horrible. It's just fucking bullshit. But enough about music. Let's move right along.
Where are we at on time?
We got a little bit yet. We can cover a couple more stories. Do you have anything you want to cover real quick?
You know what? Let me take a quick break before we get into our next thing. I just want to say, hey, make sure you are liking us and subscribing on YouTube. Make sure you are giving us reviews on iTunes, Stitcher, any of the podcasting apps. If you want to help support us, and you can do it for as little as $1 an episode, $4 a month. You pay more than that for coffee, damn it.
Starbucks.
Yeah, you can go to
Starbucks.
Yeah. You know, you can go to patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions, and if you pledge as little as $1 an episode, you know, that helps us out. If you pledge $5 an episode, you can get on our board of badasses. We haven't read those names off in a while, so I'll just go ahead and say it here quick. Our board of badasses, we have KP Smith, who's been providing valuable feedback from the beginning, and Jason Hudock, who's been providing feedback, so thank you to those two guys.
Yeah, Jason was the one where his girlfriend was on the show, Ashley.
Yeah, yeah, Ash the bag lady. Neighbor.
And that's another thing. We do have a poll going right now on Twitter. What guest do you want back?
By the time this airs, it'll be over.
I know, but I think we should extend it because it's a tie right now.
I don't know if I can extend it. Well, you know what?
You fucking better.
If it ends in a tie, I'll start it over.
We're going to have to, because there's a tie right now, and it's what guest you want to be on next. We have Hammer, we have Ashley the Neighbor, and then we have Terry the Stoner. It's a tie right now between Ashley and Terry the Stoner, so we need more votes.
Yeah, you got to get out there and vote.
Yeah, people. I think it ends like tomorrow or something like that. If not, we're going to have to extend it because it's a tie right now.
Yeah, we'll have to just resubmit the poll.
Yeah, and if Ashley, you're watching this, I hope you lose. No, I'm joking. I'm joking.
Damn.
No, she's all excited because she was winning.
Fucking ruthless. Yeah,
she was like, I'm winning. I'm the best and stuff
yeah,
like that.
Yeah, there was only one vote and she probably voted for herself.
I know. I'm just fucking with you, Ashley. I love you.
Someone has to.
Yeah. Ha! Ha! Got to do the owl flap. Ha! Ha! He just died last year.
Yeah, the midget who wore the suit.
Nah.
Not the other guy.
Nah, that sucks. That fucking sucks. But let's cover summer. This is just fucking gross.
What's that?
Oh,
look at this shit. Somebody speaking over our poll.
What's that?
We might not have a tie anymore. It looks like somebody voted for Ash.
Oh, really?
So I bet you Jason. Jason came in.
Yeah, I bet you he did. She's like, you better fucking vote for this.
Well, if it doesn't end in a tie, then we'll declare the winner.
Yeah. So I was just looking at stuff last night, and you know Aldi's. Is that a nationwide thing, or is that just an American?
Aldi's?
Or a Pennsylvania thing.
Dude, I think they even have them in the UK, because I saw some people tweeting about Aldi.
Well, this woman bought a thing of tomato juice, and this was in the bottom. I don't know what the fuck it is.
It's just a fungus. It's mold.
I know, but that doesn't look like mold, does it? And tomato juice?
Oh, yeah, absolutely looks like mold. It looks like the thing that they found in the Capri Sun pouch.
Oh, my God. It looks like fucking afterbirth, doesn't it?
Yeah, it got a pinhole in it and mold got
in. Well, that's what
they
said. They said that the air hit it or whatever like that. Yeah, there's a better view of it. See this little... it looks like an old liver, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's a fungus. It's basically a mushroom.
Oh,
I mean, yeah, it's gross, but it's, like I said, the Capri Sun thing, you know?
Yeah, they said something about how there might be, and that's, it was in Europe. They got $10.
Well, 10 euros.
What the fuck ever?
A lot of our stories come from the UK for some reason.
I know, I don't get it.
I don't know.
But I don't know, it looks like afterbirth. Like, doesn't that look like an ear that the scientists are starting to make?
It just looks like mold after they drained it out.
Ugh. I don't like it. Ugh.
I don't know. You know what? People worry way too much about food.
I know they do. People are fucking crazy about food.
I will never understand why people get upset about getting a hair in their food. We all wash our hair. Yeah, fucking pick it out and go about your day.
I don't really care either. I see what I'm like. Yeah, whatever. I've eaten pussy. That's had more hair on it than this. That's why I was like, I've eaten.
Yeah, I guarantee you put worse things than a hair in your mouth. I just don't get people. I think they just need an excuse to bitch.
Yeah, and that's the thing. This place that this lady was causing problems at or whatever like that. I have a friend that works at a restaurant, and she was saying about how this fucking girl was just pissing her off. Well, she saw her at, like, Wegmans or something like that, giving the cashier problems. And it just shows that wherever they go, they have
just like
that. Yeah, they just have to start shit. That's why we should bring back the purge or start the purge.
I just think everybody should have to do a service job once in their life.
They should.
Teach people how to respect others.
Yeah. They should, because, you know, it's fucking, people are so, and that's the thing, like, I wouldn't say I had a hard life. I wouldn't say that at all. But I'm saying, like, I've been through some shit, and it was hard for me at the time, and stuff like that. So, I've become very thankful in my life, so when I've talked about this before, when I hear people bitch, it really upsets me about stupid small shit. I'm just like, one thing that I don't get is when someone has a drink at their table, and it's, like, this full, and they're like, can I have more tea? like they're in a hurry, like they're gonna die of thirst, and it's like, motherfucker, you have almost a full glass.
Now you're getting upset over small things.
No, it's people. People aren't small things. You have to interact with them. That ain't small. That's
you need a new line of work.
Yeah, exactly. I do. You know.
Yeah, you know what?
Y'all I'd be need a porn star, but I lost my penis in Vietnam.
Y'all need to sign up for Patreon so you can get Casey out of the public. Out of working with the public.
No, we ain't ever getting rich off this, Jay. I don't know.
No, I just want to make enough money to, like, pay for all of our hosting and shit. That's all I want.
No one likes us. I don't even like
us. We will make them like us.
I know. You better like us, motherfucker.
We will keep coming into your living room week after week.
All right, one more story. I don't know if you got anything, but I'm going to cover this real quick.
Yeah, do your thing.
So Mandy Moore, that's no fucker, whatever.
She's got to be pushing like 40.
Really?
She's got to be.
I got to Google that now since you said that.
Hope your history isn't gross there.
No. I have a really good, what's that word called? Imagination. Let's see how old she is here. Mandy Moore. Oh, she's my age. She's 32.
She? Oh, damn. Yeah, I was way off.
She was born in 84. Samsonite. I was way off.
I was fucking way off. I thought she had to be pushing 40.
No. Yeah, so basically she responded to someone. Someone just bought a new apartment, and this guy tweeted about it because I guess in his apartment, he walks into the shower, and the tile was a picture of Mandy Moore.
Well, then. And it's like, a nude picture.
Yeah, no, she has a bra on.
She has a
bathing suit. Oh, she's like in a swimsuit. Okay. But someone actually put time and money into putting tile into a
bathroom. What'd she say about this creepiness?
She actually responded to it because it was on Twitter. And I forget what she said here. What'd she say? Let's see here. Where is it? She posted to it somewhere. Where the fuck is that? Oh, here it is. It's equally parts flattering and terrifying.
I would agree with that sentiment.
Like, that's so weird. Like, was that his jerk off station?
Oh my god! It's like that scene in American Beauty. Here I am jerking off in the shower. This is the highlight of my day.
Oh, I love that movie. That movie is so miserable. That's why I love it.
You are such a piece of shit.
I can't help it. I know I'm a piece of shit. I just see the world differently.
Hey, I got a movie recommendation for you people, by the way.
Oh, good.
I saw it the other day. It was very good. If you like Evil Dead, you'll like this one. It's called Bornless Ones. It's a movie. It's kind of in the same vein as Evil Dead. So, you know, cabin in the woods sort of steal possessions. But there's a cool
trees element. Trees raping you.
Not quite. But there's a cool element to it that I think is neat. In order for the demons to take possession of you, you have to be injured in some way. So it provides for some interesting scenes where, they are either injuring you or causing you to injure yourself. So that's pretty cool. And believe it or not, for being a B indie film, the acting's really done well.
Question.
Answer.
If a girl's on her period, do the demons think she's injured? That's not just me that wants to know that. I think a lot of people want to know that. Like, the demon's like, I'm not a demon, or I'm a demon, so I don't know if I, you know, should. Are you Googling this?
No, I'm trying to get some information so that y'all can understand.
No, that's just, that made me curious.
Yeah, so,
is it on Netflix? What's it on?
It's in theaters February
10th. Oh, it's a movie. I thought you said it was a show. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's coming to theaters on February 10th. I got a little preview. So when it's coming to theaters, you need to check that out.
So it's actually like a pretty shitty like quality movie, you
would say? No, not at all.
It didn't have a lot of money, you're saying.
Yeah, it was an indie movie. It's coming to theaters here February 10th. I got to, you know, because of my little hookups, I got to get a preview of it.
Yo, dog, where those movies at?
it helps to run a website about
cheeseburgers, dog.
It helps to run a website about movies and entertainment. Mm-hmm. Anyway, so it's coming to theaters February 10th. It's definitely worth checking out. So you're gonna want to see that one.
Is it from another country?
No.
Oh, okay.
Alexander Babev is the one who directed it. I guess I don't know anything about this guy.
I'll have some Babev with my caviar and crackers.
He directed, I think Bornless Ones might be his first one. Because he's got two other ones he's got directed that are coming out this year, Culture of Fear and Kiss Kiss.
Kiss Kiss.
Kiss Kiss.
I saw that they made another Pirates of the Caribbean movie. Holy fuck, man. Like, I didn't know they were making another one. And actually, fun fact.
They made all the money. Of course they're making another one.
The guy that made Captain Jack Sparrow's gun actually used to live like 10 minutes from me.
Yeah.
In Muncie, Pennsylvania. And what happened was, is he was very old. He was dying of cancer. And when the third one came out, he was basically going to be gone by then. So they actually took him to a private screening before the movie came out and showed him the movie. And then he passed away like a week later or something like that. But yeah, I found that out. I was like, what? This guy in Muncie, Pennsylvania made Jack Sparrow's gun. And they showed him. I thought that was pretty cool.
Yeah, it's neat.
Yeah, that is pretty cool.
It kind of reminds me of that kid who was dying of cancer. Ryan Reynolds took him to see a private screening of Deadpool.
Yeah. That's the cool shit. Like, yeah, I'd fucking... If I had kids look up to me, that's what I'd be doing.
I'm looking forward to the new Deadpool.
Oh, yeah, me too. Because my friend Hammer, actually, that was on the show, Cable is his favorite character. He loves Cable. And he just... Once I found out that he was going to be in the new Deadpool, like, Hammer is so excited.
I just want to see who they have play him.
Yeah. And I didn't know who Cable was, but one time I was over at Hammer's house, and he had this little figurine, and it was, like, this big, and it was sitting on his thing. And I was like, who's that? And he's like, oh, my favorite comic book superhero.
Yeah, it's Cyclops' son from the future.
Yeah, and it's time. Yeah, it's all fucking crazy. And he found it at, like, a junk store for, like, a dime or something like that when he was a kid, and he's always had it since, and it's like, and he sits it on his shelf.
I used to read the shit out of Deadpool and Cable comics. Mm-hmm. Those were, like, my favorites growing up.
Yeah, and that's a person. You guys want to ever fucking talk about comics, talk to Jay and Hammer. Like, Hammer.
No, not me. I'm nothing compared to Hammer. Like, yeah, I like comics, but Hammer's a walking comic book encyclopedia.
He's pretty fucking crazy. And he always likes the craziest shit about, like, Daken, Wolverine's kid, that can change people's hormones so he can fucking...
No, he can change his hormones.
Yeah, but he can, you know, change it to, like, make other people... Like, if he doesn't like a guy... He'll change his hormones to make that guy want to fight him so, like, he can embarrass him. Be like, hey, chill out, man. What are you getting angry for? But if there's a girl he wants to have sex with, he can make himself attracted to him and stuff. It's fucking insane.
What, one of Wolverine's multiple children that are floating around out there.
And Hammer was telling me this one book, like, I forget. I think Wolverine kills, what's his name? Beast or something. Not Beast. Sabretooth. And Sabretooth knows about Wolverine's son, Daken, and Wolverine doesn't yet. And when he's killing Sabretooth, I think this is it. Don't quote me on this, but Sabretooth's like, hey, you killed me, but you have no idea what's coming for you. Like, that's how badass this Daken guy is. And he's like, yeah, I'm dying, but you have no idea what's coming after you. Like,
you know what's kind of neat about the whole Wolverine-Sabretooth thing? Uh-huh. Every year on Wolverine's birthday, Sabretooth stalks him down and beats the shit out of him. Within an inch of his life. That is literally like their birthday ritual.
That's going to be me and yours.
Yeah. Except for I'm at your house every week.
Yeah, I know. That would just be funny. Like, that's so fucking creative. Like, to me, I don't know. That's so cool. I love weird shit like that. I think that's so interesting. Like, they hate each other, but they're still like, hey, happy birthday. Bam!
Yeah, that's like the birthday ritual. Every year, Wolverine knows on his birthday that Sabretooth's going to come and kick the shit out of him.
Oh, that's fucking hilarious. Was there anything else you wanted to cover?
No, I'm good.
That was a very geeky show. We geeked out a lot today.
Hey, that's what we do.
I know. I don't care. I don't remember geeking out this much. It's actually pretty nice.
Hey, we talk about what we want to talk about on
I got here. A little angry. At the beginning.
Your opinion was hostile.
Yeah.
Openly, in fact.
Yeah, I know. That's weird. It's like the name of the show or something.
All right, everybody. So you know the deal. You know, hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Go to Patreon. Give us money. We need your money.
Yeah, people want your fucking money. And people are starting to comment.
Like, yeah, comment, please.
Yeah, engage. Someone comment. It was nice. Like, I think I'm pretty sure they made fun of me, but whatever.
In fact, you know what? Let's be super awesome here. Let's go ahead and give this guy a little props here.
Yeah, we should, actually. That's a really good idea.
We should. I think we absolutely should. That's the least we can do, is since somebody's actually going to take the time to say something to us.
Yeah, because Jay was talking about how we play sounds just as a crutch. Now we really don't anymore, and some of us just saying about how, well, I need a soundboard when you got a Casey.
All right, so
I'm pretty sure they were busting on me, but whatever.
Yeah, yeah. Malcav1379 writes, who needs a sound effects board when you've got a Casey? So, good point.
Even if you are making fun of me, thank you for commenting. We want interaction, and we're just not getting it. we're like wives, and our husbands are truckers, so we never see them.
Yeah, we need your approval.
we want attention, or we're gonna start cheating on you.
we'll start talking to other podcasts.
Yeah, you dirty slut. Well, thanks again, everyone. Appreciate it. Tom Brady, you're still a bitch. Lady Gaga, go fuck yourself.
Hey, we didn't even mention it. This was our 20th episode.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, for everyone that stuck around since the beginning, thank you very much. I appreciate that. I forgot about that. Yeah, I
20th remember episode.
Yeah, we were talking about that yesterday. And
4 months, yeah, or 5 months.
Yeah, like we said, we're here to stay. You're getting more of us.
All right, we'll see y'all next week.
See ya. Have a good one. Goodbye.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. We are available on YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
Good morning!
Morning! Good morning!
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.